thousand things to show you. There's 50 years of collective experience that we want to give you. So we can't even really start until we talk about pulling measurements, right? So when you pull measurements, you always measure to the dead nuts center of the pipe. So when we pull measurements on a piece of, on any job site where we're gonna run up, tie into a flange, 90, 45, whatever it is, all of our measurements always take place right in the center, okay? And so if you can imagine in the center line, all measurements take place right in the center of the pipe. So we've got a center line here and a center line here, and let's say we're tying into a piece of equipment here and a tank here. So as the pipe fitter, we know we got to come out of the tank, we need to run up, 90 up, 90 over, and tie into the tank. This is what's called a takeoff. You know, the idea is to find this piece of pipe right here, what we call a pup length. Okay? So we need to figure out how long this piece of pipe is. And let's say we have our center line measurements here, and we've took a laser and we've shot these two center lines in. And let's say this is 7'6¼". We call that center to center. It's a center to center measurement because it's center of pipe to center of pipe. So we have to figure out what this pup length is, right? This is the goal as a pipe fitter, is figuring out what this pup length is. Bushki. Okay. So what we would do is we would take off for these fittings. There's a ton of different 90 style of 90. And how they attach to the pipe, because they don't all attach butt well, right? And so I think it's important that we go through a few of these different 90s and show you the differences, how they are and how they work. This is what we call a butt weld 90 because it has a butt groove weld right on the end of the 90. Okay, this is also a butt weld 90. Now you can see the differences, but one's a lot shorter. This is a short radius 90. This is a standard radius 90. We measure them from the center line of the pipe to the end where the weld is. These are two completely separate 90s. They are not the same. I said we had a standard radius, a short radius, and what we also have is what they call 3D or 3R, which you're not gonna probably run into these a lot. And we bring our center lines, up. Okay, this is the PI or the point of intersection. And so what we're measuring is we're measuring from this center to the end, right? So if I was to draw the center lines here, right, you see the PI, the point of intersection, that's where the line intersects, but we gotta take off for the 90, take off for the 90. There's three different types of fittings. there's what they call 3R. There's standard. 3R, standard, and short radius. Let's say this is 4-inch pipe. 4-inch pipe, 4 times 3. This dimension on a 3R90 from here to this center line, end of fitting to the center line, is gonna be 3 times the pipe size. 3 times 4, 12 inches. Standard, which is the most common, is 1.5 times. So you take pipe size times 1.5. 6 inches. Now for the short radius, it's gonna be whatever the pipe size is. So for 4-inch pipe, it's gonna be 4 inches. Okay, so one of the other things when we're doing math problems, I'm a big, big fan of labeling every move you make. You're out on a job site, you gotta fabricate up this, pick this thing with a crane and they go to fly it up in the rack somewhere to bolt it up, and it doesn't bolt up, you need to have a written documentation because everybody makes mistakes, you just need to learn from them. Oh, I have the center to center measurement here, right? From this center to this center. 7'6¼", and I label that. CC is how I've always done it. Center to center. This is 4-inch pipe. They're standard 90s, okay? Radius, so the takeoff of a standard radius, 4-inch 90, is 6 inches, right? 4 inches times 1.5. And we got 2 of them, because we're trying to find this puck length right here. So this is 2 4-inch 90s, right? We got our pipe laid out on jack stands. We hook our tape on one end. We go 6'6¼". We mark it. We take our beveling machine. We cut it off. We clean the ends up. We weld the fittings on. Boom. Our centers to centers are gonna work out. The other thing that I like to do is I like to circle it. I always circle them because it draws your attention to make sure you're cutting that. So now we have an answer here. It's 6'6¼", okay? Pop, I circle it. 7'6¼", that's CC, that's center to center. Always, you're always gonna label all of your dimensions. That way, if there's ever a mistake, you can always go back and you can go through that. So there again, this is 4-inch pipe. This is center to center measurement on 4-inch pipe. We talked about standard radius. Quite often in the industry, they're called long radius. Is 1.5 times pipe diameter. And then we talked about a short radius 90. Short radius is 1 times the pipe diameter. How to find that? If it was a short radius, what would the measurement be from the center line to the end where we would make the weld? And then we briefly touched in the last video about 3R, or sometimes they're called sweeps, is 3 times the pipe diameter, okay? So that's three different styles of butt weld 90s. A lot of information there, but all we're looking for is basically the only difference is the radius of that 90, how long or how short it takes place, okay? And the only thing that changes is this center line to the very end of the weld. If we do a longer radius 90, a sweep, this is obviously gonna move up, so this pup length is gonna change. If we do a short radius, it's gonna come back, it's gonna be a tighter radius, that's gonna move back here, right? But your center to your end is gonna get smaller, the pup's gotta get longer to keep up, to maintain our distances here. from these centers to these centers. What is a short radius 90 on 4-inch pipe? What is it take off? The takeoff is the pipe diameter, because it's 1 times the pipe diameter. Well, the pipe diameter is 4 inches. So it's 1 times 4, which is 4 inches. We're gonna label it just like we do. We label everything. That way, if there's ever a mistake, we know exactly where that mistake was made. We learn from it, we move on. There's two of them, right? One here, one there. Short radius 90. 7'6¼ minus 4¼.6'10¼ inches, and that's our pup length for this problem right here. If these are short radius 90s, this pup length would be 6'10¼ inch. We're gonna circle it, and we're gonna write it in here. We're gonna label this pup, because this is the pup that we're gonna cut. So if we had jack stands laid out and we had our 4-inch pipe, we'd hook the tape measure on one end, we'd pull down, we'd go 6'10¼ inch, we'd make a mark, we'd set our bevel machine, we'd cut it, we'd clean the ends up, we'd weld our 90s on, one facing one way, the other facing the other way. If you like this content, make sure you like, subscribe, tell your friends. Western Welding Academy's YouTube channel.